we're going to discuss an idea called single point modification, which is a synthetic technique, a synthetic approach that chemists use to quickly explore different functional group changes onto a molecule. Once the MedChem team establishes the core scaffold of a lead, chemists will be making many small changes to the various parts of a lead. Let's say our lead is this molecule on the main screen. Let's just also assume that our MedChem team has three chemists. Coincidentally, our lead structure has three main parts. This one ring on the left, the connection between the two rings, and then the ring on the right. Let's assume we wanted to make 10 modifications to each of these three parts. That is, we want to make 10 changes to the ring on the left. Changes might include add a chlorine, put in a nitrogen, etc. We could think of 10 changes to the other parts as well. If we made all possible combinations, we make 10 times 10 times 10, 1,000 different analogues of our lead structure. That's a lot. Instead, we can assign one chemist to make 10 modifications to each part of the rest of the molecule. So 10 changes to the left ring, 10 changes to the chain, the connection, and then 10 changes to the right ring. Individually, we'll leave the rest of the molecule the same. That would only require us to make 30 total molecules. 10 plus 10 plus 10. We'll then test all 30 molecules to determine which new group on the left ring increased the potency the most, which change to the chain increased potency, and which group on the right made the best molecule. So let's see, hypothetically, what our changes are. So our chemists are making these changes. Let's see the molecules that they came up with. So here are our three best structures based on making single changes to each part. We found a ketone on the left ring was the best, putting this aminomethyl group in on the connection was the best, and a chloro in this position was the best. So now we've made 30 molecules. Let's make one more where we incorporate all these changes. Here it is in the bottom right. This is our final lead analog, which incorporates all the changes that we highlighted. So all we did was make 10 compounds, 10 compounds, 10 plus 1, that's 31 molecules, instead of making all 1,000. This is the idea of single point modification. You break up the molecule into parts and you make single modifications to each part. The single point modification approach assumes that changes to one side of the molecule have no impact on the other side of the molecule. This assumption is not always true. Slight shifts in the position of one side will affect the positioning of the other side. These interactions are, in fact, not independent. Fortunately, for small structural changes, the assumptions of single point modification do work pretty well. So that's the idea of single point modification. It can be a real time saver. There is some risk. Maybe the interactions of the groups are not independent. However, the time savings oftentimes offsets the risk.